What's up, guys? It's Mo, and today we're doing another plan with me. This one is for the first week of March, and I am going to be using some Miss Maker paper this month, in the month of March. And I have 1,000 Miss Maker books, and then I have, I think that's called Essential Planning. So I was going to use that for some bill stickers and whatnot. And you know, I have about 300 of those Erin Condren clear rulers, but I couldn't find a single one. So I'm just mapping this out like I normally do. I do 7 spaces, and then that is the space for each day of the week. And in this case, I have had to flip one of the pages upside down because I used the graph paper on the back side of this to be the other, or to fit in with my monthly layout. So I think that the kind of, you'll notice it's kind of lopsided. I don't think it takes away from anything. Makes it look more crafty with the Miss Maker vibe. And I really do like this purple mild liner. I almost called it a midliner, mild liner. And there's some like stitching in this Miss Maker book that I thought, oh man, that'd be really cool to do the dividing lines. Why didn't I think of that? And so I end up trying it out, but it ends up not really working that well. So I'm looking for a box right now to cover the Plan a Happy Life that I have turned upside down. So I settle on this one with some scissors on it. And it's so hard for me to choose boxes. It really is. I thought, oh, I'm just going to keep with, you know, the Miss Maker sticker books, and it's going to be so easy because they all coordinate, but there's still so many daggum stickers. So I end up finding this teal and mustard colored banner, and I really, really like it. And now I'm looking for another sticker to just kind of complete the cluster there, just to make it like a group of three to kind of, I don't know, tie everything together. And then the stickers that I'm using to mark down the dates are stickers that I made in Silhouette Studio. Sometimes I use Inkscape and my Cricut Explore, and sometimes I use Silhouette and Silhouette Studio because sometimes things are easier in one versus the other. I knew that it would have been much easier for me to make an offset around the words and everything in Silhouette. It's completely doable in Inkscape. It just would have taken me a while. And that doesn't have anything to do with skill. I know some people think, oh, I can't do it because I'm not, you know, I just don't know how, or I'm not fast enough or whatever. It's just, it wasn't going to be fast enough for me. You can totally do it in Inkscape and use your Cricut Explore. You know, it's not hard. It was just, I didn't want to spend the time to do it. So now I end up using some of these little stitching kind of things that are in the Miss Maker book. I end up trying it on Monday and Tuesday, and I end up not liking it. So we have just 2 down for the week. Eventually I will chop this one and then pull it back up and put it on the other page just because I'm not liking it. I think if I had put down the stitches individually and not done the marker underneath, it might have been something that I would have liked. So, you know, I've got 1,000 of these sticker books, so I can totally go and, you know, do another Miss Maker spread. So I just lay that down there, and I end up peeling up her feet and laying that under so it goes under there. And I just keep flipping through this book. There are so many stickers, I just cannot decide on anything. I'm also filming this voiceover a couple of, I don't know, days after doing this spread, so I don't really know what I'm doing here. Putting down that sort of rainbow sticker there really pulls that scissors sticker with the full box down. I kind of, if you've seen in my other spreads, I kind of like to use a long checklist there, and so that kind of just visually creates that space for me. I try something sort of new where I put down my bills, bill due stickers in the sort of notes section, and they don't all fit, so I end up just leaving 2 of them down. I totally cannot get them straight. Like, it's ridiculous. I cannot get them straight. I picked them up and put them down about 300 times. But I think that the colors in the Essential or Planning Essentials book really do go with the Miss Maker. They'll go with a bunch of different colors that you have, you know, in your spreads for all the stickers, honestly. And I think I am trying to find like long checklist to use eventually, and I think I go between the Essential Planning or Planning Essentials and the accessory pack for Miss Maker, but I'm just creating more sticker clusters to give a little interest on the corner of the pages. I really want to use like all of the decor stickers that are in the Miss Maker sticker books. I will have Miss Maker stickers for days. And it's, like I said, it was so hard to decide what I wanted to put in each box or take from each book. It was just, it was so confusing. And I kind of wish that I had my tweezers, but I didn't have them and I didn't even think to use them here. But I have about three of these little craft cart type of things. I use them for a lot of stuff. When I was, when we moved and we stayed with my aunt for like 15 days, I used one of the craft kind of carts, those like Raskog carts, as a place to put Marcus's diapers and his clothes and his bottles. And it was like his little, you know, dresser, if you will, in their house when we stayed with them in their guest room. And it was compact. It had everything there. I mean, these carts are so versatile. So I just put that little glitter. It's like a clear sticker with some glitter on it. And here I am looking for the checklist, but I put the glitter stickers down in the space that you'll see is the lopsided space, if you will, from me having to flip the pages over. I end up not liking those checklist though. They don't fit the lines properly. And then I end up using the ones from the Miss Maker accessory pack. They don't fit the lines properly either, but at least they look a little bit better. I don't know if I like these in general. I really like to use the type of ones from the Colorful Boxes sticker book that I have. Those are the ones that fit perfectly in there. They don't line up with every line on the spaces I've created, but they line up with a lot of them. So then I'm just adding more of the deco kind of stickers to the Wednesday box, and I'm trying to figure out where I can fit this sticker book. It ends up not looking right anywhere, so I put it back in the book, which is really unfortunate because I really like the sticker book stuff. I also made a Miss Maker micro notes. If you want to see that video, I'll have that linked below and above in one of the cards. I can't get enough of the Miss Maker sticker books, and I will have enough Miss Maker sticker books until, you know, I don't need to plan anything anymore. So yeah, I really like how this spread is coming together. When I was filming this, I was downstairs, and so I did not have my Colorful Boxes books either, I don't think. I think they were upstairs, and then I was trying to find ways to mark certain things in this planner, and there weren't too many boxes that I really wanted to use in the Miss Maker sticker book. So that was kind of a struggle for me. And having so many stickers to choose from in the book was really like, what am I going to use? Can I use this one? Can I use that one? But I need to come up with other things to do using the Miss Maker stickers that I have hoarded. I do have a spread that you'll probably see on Instagram or maybe in my March flip through that I did using the Socialite book. And I did a DIY dashboard layout. And I kind of really liked that one. I thought that one looked cute as well. I didn't film it. I decorated a couple weeks ahead, but I did not film it because I just wanted to be creative. I'm looking through the mini Miss Maker book now, and it's got some stuff I'm trying to find like boxes to use. So I put this down and I end up finding a black marker to kind of make stitching around it, you know, and that kind of gives it the Miss Maker crafty vibe, but I end up not liking it. So I take that up. Ultimately, I end up going with the like tag looking boxes, these right here. I end up going with these. They're kind of big, but you know what you gotta do. What you gonna do? So I end up using those. It's not my favorite. I wish they were smaller. I don't really like the scallop ones. I don't really like the ones with the call outs. It just, I don't know. And then I put down the popcorn bag there for our movie night. We've been doing movie night every Saturday for the most part. I think we had to do one on a Friday night at one point, but we've been doing movie night every night for a long, long, long time. Probably, was it in February that we started? I don't know. It might have been January, but it's really good. It's just time for Zach and I. We watch a movie. We watched Lock and Key at one point. That was a big binge watching thing. I think I think we watched one or two episodes, and then we just kept on our movie night, and then we just kept watching, you know, throughout the week. So it's really hard, I think, for us to get started on different movies and series and stuff. I don't know. I can never make decisions. So now I'm trying to see if I can use any of the sticky notes at all. And I really can't, but I think that this is the end of the spread. I think I'm pretty satisfied with it. You'll see in the next March flip through that I did add some stickers to the ones that are those little tag boxes that I used from the Joann's Mega sticker book, like they say today and to do and things like that. I pulled some of those out and stuck them in the back folder of my of my planner. So now I'm just filling in some white space that I think I don't want to see on my planner. But I had a fun time making this little spread. I think it's something that maybe I might, I don't know, not have really done if it weren't for this spread. I don't know. I feel like it doesn't fit in with my aesthetic, but it kind of does. So I hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up and subscribe. I would love for you to stick around, and I will talk to you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.